This is the Charles Cook Podcast, where lovers of liberty and individual rights in Tennessee go to get information, focusing on state and local issues from Bristol to Memphis, discussing the important issues with facts, truths, and opinions based on constitutional principles. Remember, we stimulate, but never indoctrinate your mind. Welcome to the Charles Cook Podcast.
Well, hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us again today for another podcast. I'm stepping outside of my normal podcast and not talking about politics today. Actually trying to help some folks. I believe in helping good organizations with their message and getting the word out. So today I have Amber Kennedy. She is from Sumner County, Tennessee, and she is working as the expansion coordinator for the Sumner County Isaiah 117 house. So Amber, welcome, and tell us kind of where you all are right now with getting this house up and going. Well, first of all, tell them what the Isaiah house does.
Okay, so the Isaiah house steps in on removal day for children. Typically right now in Sumner County, when a child goes, is taken from by the state and removed from the only mother and father they've ever known, they go to Maple Street, to an office building. They have to sit there and wait for placement. Sometimes that can be up to a couple of hours, up to a couple of days in an office building. So what we want to do, and what other counties and our surrounding counties have already done, is built an Isaiah 117 house. This house will look just like the house that you and I live in. When they come in with the DCS workers, we'll be able to love on the DCS workers and the children alike. We'll be able to replace those trash bags. So many times a child comes into placement with a trash bag and that's all they have. We'll replace that trash bag with a new backpack or a duffel bag, new clothes. We'll be able to love on them, be able to treat them for lice before they go into placement, or do whatever they need to be able to give them a great, great start into placement to foster care. We also want to love on our DCS workers. All of our homes are built with a great office space for our DCS workers. They will have all of the computers and the printers and everything they need there to be able to do their work there in the office. And then we'll just love on the children for them. So that's kind of what a roundabout idea of kind of what the DCS or what the Isaiah 117 house does.
Okay. So it's basically is kind of like the entrance into foster home. Is that correct?
Sort of. Yes. We're definitely not a foster home because they can stay overnight in our homes. Like I said, they'll have bedrooms, all those types of things, but it's not for long term. It's getting right. Them ready for placement.
Right. So it's beginning steps for kids who are in risky situations, situations that are not good. Right. So, and it's getting them into a stable situation, hopefully to work towards getting them into a foster home. Is that correct?
Right. Yes, okay. Sir.
So I know that a lot of... we have this in my county, mm-hmm. where I'm from, and the lady here has done a fantastic job with it. I know a lot of churches and stuff are involved in these houses in these counties. So, mm-hmm. and I know there's a lot of work goes into it. So where are you all at with constructing or putting this house together?
So we kicked off in January. And we had our big fundraiser this past September, at the end of September, the September 26th, I believe was the date. And we were able to raise enough money to be able to break ground on the land. We had a donation from a church that donated the land to us. It's been perked, and we are waiting for the official paperwork from that perk to come back. And as soon as that comes back and we have that paperwork in hand, then we'll be able to transfer the land over into the Isaiah name. And then at that point, then we can start pulling all of the paperwork we need to be able to start building. So we're looking to probably have our construction breakfast, which that means that we'll be inviting all of the different constructors and construction workers and the subcontractors and all of those type of people in to a breakfast that hopefully we're shooting for sometime in January, maybe February, by the time all the paperwork is finalized, and then hopefully be able to break ground very soon after that.
Okay, great. And I do have your email address just scrolling mm-hmm. across the bottom of the screen. If anyone would like to reach out and maybe volunteer or make donations, or yes. other churches in the area, in your county would like to reach out and get involved in this. I know it's a great opportunity to get a church for a church to take up something like this to get involved in.
I love speaking at churches. So anytime if there's any churches out there that would like for me to come and speak and give them a little rundown of what we are, I can take about 30 minutes and I would love to come speak.
Yes. And I do know that the director of the one here in Hamlin County has done that as well. So, you know, mm-hmm. I would say, folks, she done a fantastic presentation, a lot of good pictures and everything. So I say if you have that opportunity, invite Amber in and let her do the presentation for your church. So you're basically in the beginning stages with this. You haven't really even broke ground for this yet. What do you all need? What are y'all looking for from your community right now to help you once this perk is approved to move forward?
Well, we're already looking for volunteers. I am sitting in a church right now, and we just finished our expansion meeting with some of our volunteers just a few moments ago, and we made blankets for children to be able to hand out to the DCS workers there to be able to give to the children. So we're already taking donations of new clothes and anything like that that a child would need, but we're also monetary. But then we're also looking for volunteers to come with me whenever I speak to help sell t-shirts or talk to the children or the kids that I'm doing a trunk or treat here in a few weeks, or actually this weekend. And so we're looking for volunteers to come and help us with that, to be able to just hand out candy while I speak to the parents about the Isaiah House. So we're always looking for volunteers to help in different things. We love on our DCS workers every month. So we're always looking for volunteers to come help us with the different things that we do for them, whether it's a cookout or a special meal, or maybe it's just something small, a token of our love to them. So we're always looking for volunteers to come and get involved with us.
Great. Now, for the folks who are seeing this in Sumner County, do you want to tell them what the location is that you all are planning on building, or is you trying to keep at?
I can't say the exact address, but we are going to be in the Cottontown area.
Okay. So for the folks down there, they should know basically where that's at.
They'll know. It's a small little area in Sumner County. Sumner County is a pretty large county, but it's a small little area that we will be in the Cottontown area. Yeah. So we're super excited. I'm excited about the church that donated us this land. And how they are diving in and helping us and getting involved. We have several different churches in the area that's involved right now with us, but we're always looking for more.
Okay. And for folks who don't know, who are outside of Sumner County and maybe from West Tennessee or East Tennessee that see this as well. So Sumner County is just north of Davidson County, which mm-hmm. Davidson is where Nashville is. So it would be, to Portland, Gallatin mm-hmm. area.
Hendersonville, Westmoreland, a little bit of White House. That's kind of our major cities that's in our.
So that would be an area up there. So I know that a lot of counties have a great need for these houses. And mm-hmm. The world is not getting any better. And there's a lot of kids that are left. You know, even grandparents and great grandparents are raising kids now today. But so these houses are very important to help with the community and everything, especially with the kids that are being taken out of very bad situations. So if there's any way that you folks can help Amber there in Sumner County, I would ask that you do that and reach out and see what you can do.
We actually have 27 open homes across 12 different states.
Yeah. And it's really growing. I know it's really growing here in Tennessee. I think they have some up in the Tri-Cities area. Mm-hmm. We have them here in Hamlin County. And so it's growing across the state and then across the country. So it's going to be, it's great. It's really needed in this day and time.
Yes.
Do you have anything else that you would like to add to this? Any information that you'd want the folks in Sumner County to know or anything?
We have an expansion meeting the third Sunday of every month at Cross Point Church here in Hendersonville. It starts at 2:00. It lasts about an hour. We discuss things that are going on in our community and how we can get involved in them, different ways that Isaiah House can grow in our community and how we can help others and the children here in our community. So that's a very important way, an easy way to come and get involved with that. More the merrier. Sometimes we have snacks, sometimes we do activities, but that's a great way to come and get involved and learn more about us and what we're doing.
Okay, sounds great. And so folks, I would just say, if you're interested in this or you would like to have Amber come and speak and tell you or your church or your organization more about what's going on, I just say reach out to one of the email addresses scrolling across the bottom of the screen and reach out to Amber or the folks that's working with her, and I'm sure she'd be happy to come out and talk with you. So, you know, as I said, I've seen it here with the lady that's running the house here in my county. It's it's doing great. Have people that really have a passion for this and really want to see these things grow. So reach out to Amber and maybe you can get involved and help this thing get done quicker. I'm sure they needed it 2 weeks ago. And right. And so much needed things in every houses in every county to help the kids. Okay. Anything else you want to add before we?
No, just reach out to me if you'd like to be involved. If you have other questions or concerns or anything at all, I would love to sit down, have coffee, talk about what's going on in our community and how we can help and how we can become partners.
Okay. And one other thing, have you had anyone reach out from your local city councils or county governments to kind of help you with this?
Not a whole lot. We haven't. We've had bits and pieces. A couple of, we did have a senator that came and we talked to, but other than that, that's about all we've done. Most of our traffic has been out of the Portland Gallatin area.
Okay. Well, folks, any of you locally elected government officials want to get involved and help with something like this, this is a great opportunity for you to do something outside of government to help needy children. So get involved with this and reach out to Amber, and I'm sure she can tell you how you guys can help to get this done. So with that, Amber, I thank you for joining me today, and hopefully I can help you spread this message and get you guys up and going before you know it.
Great. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. So with that, I thank you folks for joining me. Spread this message, this video or the podcast, audio or video, either way you listen to it or watch it, spread it there in Sumner County. Let's get the word out. Let's get this done for the kids that's going to need this in the future. With that, have a great day. God bless you, and we'll see you on the next podcast. Bye-bye. Thank you.